Hello there, international movie friends. We got some Mandalorian news that just came out today. We got our first look at Mandalorian Season 2 through Entertainment Weekly. Last week, we already talked about the Mandalorian. When is the trailer coming, Koen? Trailer is still not here, but the marketing campaign is ramping up as it seems, because now we get the first look on some of the photos that were taken on set. There were some interviews being done in Entertainment Weekly. So we will take a look at the photos, take a look at some things that are said, see if we have a certain opinion about it. We can already see right away here, Koen, the front of cover of Entertainment Weekly. Well, here he is, of course. There can be nobody else on the front cover.
Of course.
That's Baby Yoda, indeed. Exactly. He looks quite like a puppet over here, not as real as in the series.
Yeah, exactly. It's more like a puppet here, yeah.
But always good to see the cute boy or girl. Do we know actually if it's a boy or a girl?
Yeah, no, everybody thinks it's a girl, but I don't know why we think that actually.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah,
I assumed a boy.
Yeah, I don't know actually why, but... yeah, good question, actually. We don't even know, I think, yeah.
No, I think we didn't find out in the first season yet. If people watching do know, let us know in the comments. But maybe that's the big thing we will find out in the second season, the gender of Baby Yoda. Yeah,
gender revealing party.
Exactly.
Everything pink or blue, yeah. Nice.
There will be something. Okay, so then we get this shot. This is quite cute with little Baby Yoda here in the back of the Mandalorian.
Perfect,
yes. So we got those two front covers, and then to dive into a quote that we got from Jon Favreau, the creator, of course, of The Mandalorian. He says, this new season is about introducing a larger story in the world. The stories become less isolated, yet each episode has its own flavor, and hopefully we're bringing a lot more scope to the show. The next thing he said I found quite interesting. As we introduce other characters, there are opportunities to follow different storylines. The world was really captivated by Game of Thrones and how that evolves as the characters follow different storylines. That's very appealing to me as an audience member. So, yeah, it seems here that we might be moving more towards a Game of Thrones kind of setup with different storylines at the same time that in the end maybe come together.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, I think so. I think when The Mandalorian was announced and... there were a lot of people talking about that they could really make this Game of Thrones kind of show and setup for The Mandalorian. And the first season wasn't like that, of course. So some people were a bit disappointed by that, I think, because they thought it would be a bit more Game of Thrones style. But by this quote, you might assume that they maybe move into that direction.
But also it sounds like they need to then, also possible not to follow for, let's say, 50 minutes not to follow the Mandalorian at all and to follow like some other character, but it really depends on who they want to follow and who they will go into depth with, which is very interesting.
Yeah, well, we know, of course, that the cast gets quite bigger. We will get Ahsoka Tano in this season, which is a huge character, of course, in Clone Wars and in Rebels. So we might see quite a bit more of her. We will have Bo-Katan, played by Katie Sackhoff. She will be in there. We will have probably some version of Boba Fett in this show. We will have also Michael Biehn and Timothy Olyphant, who we don't know yet who they will play. So there's quite some new actors also in this season.
The Boba Fett character is going to be played by the same guy you said last time?
He's going to be played by Temuera Morrison, and he's the guy who played Jango Fett in the prequels.
Yeah, in the... but especially in the last movie from George Lucas that we saw, no? The Clone Wars.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, cool. Okay.
So it's the exact actor that played Jango Fett, not the actor that played Boba Fett, because there was a little boy, of course.
Of course, I understand. Yeah.
Exactly. So yeah, maybe they zoom in a bit more on those characters, or maybe, of course, we also still got Gina Carano, who plays Cara Dune, and we got the Carl Weathers guy, of course, who's still confirmed in this season. So there's plenty of characters for that matter. But yeah, I found this an interesting quote.
Do you expect any Jedis to show up, you think?
I'm not sure, but by some quotes we get later on in this article by Entertainment Weekly, I got the feeling like maybe we will get to something like that. It might be at the end. Of course, we get Ahsoka Tano, who is sort of a Jedi, like a gray Jedi, so to say.
Yeah, exactly. But because I forgot again the time frame. We're before they built the new star. That new planet from the First Order, no?
Yeah, the Starkiller base, yeah.
So after the first six movies?
Yeah.
In between the first six and then the new three?
Yeah, I think it's more or less 3 or 4 years after Return of the Jedi. So it's more or less the decline of the Empire. So they're still dealing with the remnants of the Empire. But the First Order is not yet there. But I might assume as this series moves forward, and we might get into a third season because it's already in development also, that I wouldn't be surprised if they will make connecting storylines with the First Order, so we get a hint at that's for the first time.
And then
that would be cool.
Luke is still alive then.
Luke is still alive, yeah.
He's most probably teaching then on that island before it went wrong.
Yeah. So you know what they are saying, that Sebastian Stan, I don't know if you saw those photos, two photos of Luke and Sebastian Stan.
No.
Yeah, Hamill at a young age and Sebastian Stan, and it's uncanny how much they look alike.
Oh, really? It resembles a bit of if I see it in my head now. But
I will put it in this video later on in the edit so the people watching can see it. So yeah, that could be, of course. So would be interesting, yeah. So yeah, to move on, we get this photo. This is the first one of the first new photos we get. Again, we see the Mandalorian here with baby Yoda. We don't know for sure, of course, if Pedro Pascal is really in the suit, because in the first season a lot of shots were done without him. But we see him here. What we can see on this photo here is the emblem that he has on his
or a rhino or something. Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's what he chose in the first season as his sign. Mm-hmm, that's what we can see very prominently over here.
Yeah.
It's quite interesting. Then we get this photo.
Nice.
Yeah. Speeder bike.
Yoda still in the back, yeah,
in the back. It looks like Tatooine again.
Yeah, I want
like
to say the same thing. Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
it would be interesting if they went back there again. I always like to see Tatooine.
Yeah. He still has a jetpack, I saw.
So then we get this quote from Pedro Pascal saying, we start very directly after the first season, and he's going into very dangerous territory. He's very much a passenger to the experience in unexpected ways, not knowing what's to come, not knowing how much or how best to protect the child. So that's the quote from Pedro Pascal in Entertainment Weekly. So yeah, we might expect that there's some inner struggles going on, which is interesting, because we call also later on with a quote from this guy, Giancarlo Esposito, who plays, of course, Moff Gideon. And he has something interesting to say, saying, I'll be going toe-to-toe with Mando. It's an iconic battle. I want to disarm him mentally as well. Maybe there's an opportunity to get him to fight some battles for me. You might think I'm a villain, but I'm trying to harness some energy and some powers for a path that could be best for all. Exactly. So, by the way, this sounds, and also the quote we heard before from Pedro Pascal, the Mandalorian is getting some struggles of which direction he should go, and maybe... Mm-hmm. Get tempted by sort of a dark side.
Or maybe he realizes, maybe there's a moment that he says, also, I'm going to do more dangerous territory, that it's almost impossible to, he needs some help maybe, and maybe he needs help from a guy that is the lesser of the two evils or something, maybe.
Yeah, that could be. That they team up together against a bigger threat.
Yeah, maybe.
Could be. Maybe Boba Fett, who knows? Yeah, so that was quite an interesting yeah. one. So he says more or less we shouldn't see him as the villain, but yeah, that's what a true villain would say, of course. So
of course. They think I'm a villain, but I'm only trying to do good. Yeah.
Exactly. then we get a new shot on Gina Carano playing Cara Dune. Well, not much to say from the background. That she looks someone that kicks ass again in the second season. She also had a quote in her interview. Well, first we get this shot also with the crew. We see the Mandalorian, and in the back we see Grief Karga was his name, I think, played by Carl Weathers. And we see Gina Carano, Cara Dune. And then Gina Carano said, "I have no question fans are going to like this season even more, everything in there. If you're a Star Wars fan, you're going to get to see things you always wanted to see."
Okay, so Jedi's for sure.
Exactly. That's what I hear also felt, yeah.
For sure, yeah.
Yeah, that's the quote that made me feel like, okay, we're going to get some, fan service, you may call it, but we're going to get probably a bit more Force Jedi-related stuff, I would think.
How cool would it be if Luke Skywalker showed up again, really?
Yeah, or it could also be, of course, because we never saw Yoda's planet. And a lot of people are always have been curious about that. So it could also be that that's what she's hinting on. Like, we will get to see something that Star Wars fans always wanted to see, in that being Yoda's planet.
Yeah, because the planet where he's in Return of the Jedi, that's just the one that he was hiding, no?
Yeah, Dagobah. He went into exile there.
But is there a name for Yoda's planet?
Nay, there's no name for his
there's
no name for his species. There's very little known about his background.
So it might live like thousands of years, but
yeah, exactly.
Okay,
so, that's interesting. So that might also be that she's referring to that over here.
Okay, yeah, good one. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. So then we get this extra shot from I think they're called the Bantas. Exactly. Yeah, I read that they speeded up the edit they speed up the pace more or less, so you get this more or less repetitive.
Oh, really?
It was not filmed like that, I think, if I remember correctly. But yeah, so that's fun. We get that shot, and then we get one last shot here on Grief Karga. He seems to have some different outfits than he had in the first one, some purples and some insignia on his chest.
Upgraded or something, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. I also get the feeling from this photo that he's now definitely more on the side of the Mandalorian and also Cara Dune, where in the first one, of course, he was still a bit in between area.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Exactly. So that's the photos. We also got a bit more information on there will be 8 episodes again, 8 episodes of different lengths again. So just like with the first season, not set yet if they will be longer or what we wished for a bit, of course. We don't know yet. Directors will be returning Riki Fumiyawa, who did the fifth or the fourth episode, I believe, in the first season. We got Carl Weathers, this guy here to our right, who will also direct now an episode. Robert Rodriguez will do one episode, who also did Alita Battle Angel. And I think Dave Filoni was also doing one. And we get for the first time John Favreau himself directing one.
He didn't direct any of the first season?
No, he was the producer, was the man who created the creator, so to say. Cool. But he didn't direct because of scheduling issues with Lion King, I believe. For this one. For this one he is. Then one thing, funny thing also that Gina Carano said, that she stated there was a lot of secrecy around the second season, that actors got their scripts only for their episodes and they were brought to sets in black cloaks and hoods. So apparently so.
Awesome.
Exactly. So journalists wouldn't see who they were playing. So that's also, again, hinting at probably we are in for some shockers again with this.
I think they will bring someone back from the past.
Yes, I think
Or they bring some, like if you say with Stan, they bring maybe a younger version. But I don't think they will do that to Mark Hamill because he's not.
Nee.
Yeah, but on the other side, no, they also don't need to because he's already old, so they can make him a little bit younger, and it's fine, I think.
Yeah, yeah, it will be interesting. We probably will see some shockers.
What do you think? What do you expect? What name one or two that you really wish for that also fit the story, you think, and one or two you think are most likely and most logical?
Well, I already like that we're getting Ahsoka. That we already know. I don't think they will go that route. I don't think they will put Mark Hamill or Luke Skywalker or Princess Leia. I don't think they will put those in again because I have the feeling they want to steer a bit away from those and create their own little world. It might be that they have some other characters. Lando, I wouldn't be completely surprised if Lando.
Donald Glover.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, would be nice. He played it good the last time. Yeah.
Yes, exactly. And his age, of course, also suits. So yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if he turns up.
Okay.
But yeah, what I hope to get at least some more lightsaber. We got the darksaber now. I would like to have a lightsaber battle in some capacity since we know that Ahsoka will be in there. I hope for that and some, mm-hmm. yeah, some more force-related stuff, yeah, which was, yeah, of course, now Baby Yoda had some of those scenes, but I would like to see a bit more of that. And I do like tie-ins to source material, to the books, to the old movies, even if it's just mentions here and there. I always like that kind of stuff. So that would be it, I think, for you.
Yeah, I'm thinking who else. Like, I would always like to see Mark Hamill because I like him, and wouldn't be bad. But I think you're right. Maybe it doesn't fit the style. They want to go in between, but then also like they want to pay tribute to, but without using again those guys and women. But I'm thinking who else. Like in the time frame, Lando would be very logical, I think.
Han Solo, maybe played by Alden Ehrenreich.
But it'll be also really cool. Chewbacca, then.
Yeah.
Maybe Chewbacca is the only one from the old ones that actually it wouldn't matter so much if he was in it somehow, you know?
Or R2-D2 in the background.
Yeah. I was thinking of the really big fat one, but he died, of course, already before, no? The bad guy.
Jabba the Hutt.
He died, no?
Yeah, he died.
I forgot the time frame, but it would have been awesome. But
Okay, for our movie friends watching, let us know in the comments who you would like to see in this second season of The Mandalorian. We are very curious what you think. We will keep a very close eye on this series. We will do episode-by-episode reviews as soon as the episodes come out. Yes, exactly. We will react to the trailer as soon as it's out. So if you want to stay updated on everything Mandalorian Season 2, subscribe to our channel. And if you like this video, please hit the like button. Koen, it was nice talking with you again.
Yeah,
I have spoken, and goodbye.
This is the way.
This is the way.